Hello again, YouTubers. I'm at SpongeBob 101, back here again on day number 9 of our 5th anniversary celebration. So, if you haven't checked out yesterday's video, which was for Thanksgiving, we had a 5th anniversary giveaway on that. Make sure to go over there and enter. And also, we are going to be having that mini Q&A session for tomorrow's video, the finale. So, make sure to send in your questions. Instructions on how you can do that is in the description box below. Playlist link to all the 5th anniversary celebration videos is also in the description box below. And now, welcome to an all new video series featuring video games, alright? So SpongeBob Video Games, we actually haven't done anything for it except for a few unboxings. Way back in 2011 when I unboxed the SpongeBob SquarePantis Wii game, and in 2013 when we unboxed the creature from the Krusty Krab game, I believe I also unboxed Plankton's Robotic Revenge in 2013. So yeah, but basically that's all what we've done so far, and therefore, this new video series is going to be focusing on the stuff that we haven't featured yet, and that's all the games that we got prior to 2011. Alright, so I just realized I think I unboxed Boating Bash on YouTube as well. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did in 2012. So, actually we did quite a bit, but okay, anyway. We haven't done this one before because, well, I got this in 2009. Anyways, this is Atlantis SquarePantis for the Wii. This is actually one of, in my personal opinion, I think this is actually still way better than Plankton's Robotic Revenge or SpongeBob Hero Pants for that matter. And, I'm, like, you know, across all the reviews and everything, I realize that people don't really enjoy this game for certain reasons, such as the game being a little bit lengthy or way too short. You had these mini games that were really annoying. There was no real pull factor for this game, basically. But actually, I beg to differ in that aspect. The first thing is that I really enjoyed the music. While some of the music was actually ported over from Creature from the Krusty Krab, but they didn't just port it over, they actually revamped it and made it fit into this game. So I guess we had to praise them for that, right? Blitz Games. So yeah, here is the cover. THQ, this was published in November 2007. This is the side there, and on the back, yeah, you guys can just pause and read. So basically how this will actually go is that we'll actually be doing the physical review first, and then we'll be reviewing the levels one by one with the actual footage from the game. So that will be after we finish this part. So yeah, each video will be about 8 to 9 minutes. And yeah, so basically you need a nunchuck because there are 4 different types of levels. So yeah, that's basically the back. Let me just show you what's inside. So first we have the disc, which is actually pretty cool. SpongeBob blowing that sponge bubble there. And we have the manual, which is practically non-existent in the current games. Play THQ. Okay, so there's a contents page. Getting started. Controls. So actually, I think this game is actually pretty easy to play. It's just that, you know, the rewards you get here is basically amulets. And unlike Creature from the Krusty Krab, where you get the Z points or whatever you want to call it, essentially, these ones you have to complete the level to and win a certain like bronze, silver, or gold amulet, so you can actually purchase items in the Atlantian gift shop, which every item costs 2 amulets. So basically, winning a bronze will give you 1 amulet, silver will give you 2 amulets, and a gold will give you 3 amulets. Of course, like Creature from the Questy Crab, there was also a random extra SpongeBob spare face, as well as the arcade games, which are actually pretty cool. I like the music. Action Adventure Atlantis SquarePantis. I have these two. Maybe I'll do a review on those one day. Okay, and yeah, so that's basically the manual. And that's a physical review. So, before I begin the level reviews, what are my thoughts on the game? Well, actually, personally, I feel that it's a little bit difficult. Not as easy as you might think, especially on level 7 and level 13, which you'll understand why later, as well as level 6 and level 10, which are the platforming levels. And those are totally zoomed out, it's 2D, and those are the levels that I'm quite annoyed with. The tank level is pretty cool, but you know, it really hurts the thumb, so but before I dive right into the levels, Atlantis SquarePantis, I give it a 3 out of 5. A pretty decent game, I like the artwork there. The game is actually very well polished. It's just that the content may not be as engaging as you might want it to be. I don't see any bugs or glitches or anything, and the animation is actually pretty okay, I guess. I mean, it was just like, it was more of 2D-ish, weirdish, but still okay as compared to the current Activision games, which don't have mouse moving at all. So yeah. Alright, so anyways, we're gonna take a look at the levels 1 to 14, beginning right now.
SpongeBob's trip to Atlantis end this way. Who can stop Plankton's rampage of destruction? Do you want to drive a really cool tank?
Right, so first up is Plankton's Plankpantis, and basically you're driving a truck as Plankton for 7 minutes of around 7 minutes of blast and stuff to get to the end of the game. Basically, just like this kind of flashback thing. So actually, decent 3 out of 5. Next up, Amulet Adventure, we have a platforming level. You're supposed to play as SpongeBob Patrick to get to the bottom of the cave at the start of the TV movie, and you're supposed to find the Amulet of Atlantis. So this is actually pretty awesome, but it's quite long, so also 3 out of 5. Next up, Snap Happy. Yeah, so basically you're supposed to take pictures, avoid security, and shoot Krabby Patties at visitors just for fun to get them out of the way. And so basically that's your goals. Pretty cool, 4 out of 5. And next one, Magical Bus Journey, I think. It speaks for itself. I mean, just take a look at this. I mean, this music is epic, alright? Epic. I'm telling you that. So, 5 out of 5, Bus Building Bonanza. Basically, you're supposed to drive around Atlantis collecting 2 boxes to fix the bus, and eventually you get to meet the king at the palace. Isn't that great? I really like this game, I mean this part of the game. 4 out of 5, awesome. I like the driving, to be honest. Next up, we have Tour Trouble. Basically, it's like the first level 4, but this time you're supposed to be on a tour and you're supposed to avoid booby traps and all that really annoying stuff. Also very long and very tedious, so 2.5 out of 5. Next one, Money Crabbing. Basically, you're supposed to play as Mr. Krabs and shoot these jewels and get combos to, you know, rank up scores and get amulets. So, pretty simple, I guess, but to me it's really hard to actually win. That one, 2 out of 5.
Squidward the poser. Supposed to pose, press the Wii buttons or anything, all the buttons, and in a pattern, and you pose. And yeah, at the end of the level, at the end of each part, you get an artwork, and like that. Yeah, 4 out of 5 is really cool. Next one, we have a level 3 remake in Atlantis, and this time, your security guards are like these Atlanteans thingies, I think. Yeah, cool. 3 out of 5. Not as cool as the first one though. And yeah, we had the worst level in this entire game, hide and seek, or hide and sneak. And this one I'm giving a 2 out of 5 because it's so long and so hard to finish, especially its variations. And yes, there are variations in this game. Level 11, we have Armory Antics. You're playing as Plankton, you know, playing the pattern thing again, and just not trying not to get caught. So don't get caught, and you're fine. It's a shorter level, so it's easier to play. 3 out of 5. Yeah, this one is the Squidward Super Shooter, and this is really cool because you actually use Squidward as like the shooter, and you're supposed to shoot. What's that? Balls, I don't know. The guards, which is really cool. And that's 4 out of 5. Really nice. Last, the 13th level is the hardest in terms of like arm or finger strength. Yeah, really can wear you out a lot. And it's really long. I mean, unless you really, you know, have the tricks and everything. So I'll give it a 2.5 out of 5. And last level, we have Operation Trash Dash. So it's basically like a credits level, although I skipped the credits part in this video, just so you can see the ending. So yeah, that's about it. 4 out of 5 for this one. I like it a little bit. And yeah, make sure to subscribe, like, favorite, comment, etc. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to keep right here on Ultimate SpongeBob 101. Hope you guys enjoy this new video type. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Tomorrow for the finale. Bye!